very good morning to everyone who has taken time to travel and come today to attend this meeting on a World Cup final day. We've had more than 100% registrations, and because it seemed everyone is very interested in listening to a great speaker, it was a professional courtesy extended even while the laptop was not getting connected to the projector, that, you know, if all agreed, we could have always waited for some time. And since, you know, if it is difficult to wait, we can always express ourselves. I'll quickly like to take a minute to just simply state ATMA is a pure volunteer effort. Everybody is extremely busy with their lives and work, and some people are able to find the time and energy to contribute volunteer work. Things, of course, at a volunteer enterprise or a commercial one can always keep improving. That's what human life is all about, constant improvement. Yet, you know, there are two ways to respond to situations and problems. Either we can find faults or we can do something about it. And I'm sure as momentum keeps gathering on, and proof of seriously high momentum is that we have this room nearly full. Some more will come, and by the time, you know, we are into the presentation, it will be more than full. That things are improving, and as momentum gathers, more volunteers will take up initiatives. And I think it is difficult for anyone to, you know, come here previous night to sit down and check if a cable is working or not. The human element is always there. So I believe, you know, professionalism is about dependable and regular work. We are regular, and we are as dependable as one can be. And sometimes, you know, when despite all of this, some things will not work. It happens all the time in the markets, you know, your pattern failures, your indicator failures, the internet will fail precisely only when you take a large position. You have two choices. Either you can kick your screen and break your laptop, or you can take a stop loss. And I think, you know, those who accumulate wealth and wisdom choose stop loss. Having said this, let me not consume more time today this morning. We have an illustrious achiever amongst us today who's taken time to come and share his wisdom and knowledge with us. I'll like to welcome Dr. Joshi. I'll give you a very brief introduction about him, and I'm sure, you know, all of us will keep discovering more facets to him as we will interact with him more through the presentation and beyond. He is a trained psychologist who's practiced for 20 years. And in the last 8 years, he's also been into serious technical analysis and trading himself. He's written two very interesting books on the subject that have sold very well. And he has been on the speaking circuit for quite some time, speaking at illustrious places like Asia Traders and Investors Conference. He's trained for Dun & Bradstreet, and he's been a visiting faculty for management graduates at Faculty of Management Studies, graduate students at Xavier Institute of Management Research, Indian Institute of Capital Markets, Institute for Technology and Management have all benefited from his talks to them. And he has conducted workshops for Reliance Money, ICICI Bank, JP Morgan, Kotak, Multi Commodity Exchange, etc. Time Your Trades with Technical Analysis and Magic and Logic of Elliott Waves are two of his fairly well accepted books, and some of us will look through and browse through them. And Dr. Joshi is a member of the MTA as well as the ATMA, and the discussion forum on the website is the place from where, you know, even in a cyber world, we can continue to take this discussion forward and keep sharing and learning from him. So let me take this opportunity of welcoming Dr. Joshi, please. Though we have managed to connect the laptop in some way, some minor glitches and some adjustments may be there, and I'm sure no one will take a stop loss on a giant trade like listening to Dr. Joshi.
I'm very happy to be here today for two reasons. First is I like to talk. And as a trained psychiatrist and having practiced for 20 years, all my life I have always listened to people. And at my home, I don't get a chance to speak. So I look forward to all such opportunities. So I would like to, at the beginning, only thank Mr. Sushil Kedia for calling me here to do something which I enjoy very much. But a second reason why I am happy today is I am happy to be amongst fellow colleagues who speak the same language as me, who understand the same language as me, and who probably have same aversions as me, for example, reading Economic Times or something like that. So it's always good to interact, you feel very good to interact with people who speak the same language, who understand the same language, and who share similar experiences. This lecture today is going to be a bit different than usual lectures. Usual lectures are knowledge-giving lectures. Now, in this lecture, I am not here to give you some kind of great knowledge wherein, whatever you have not even heard anywhere, nothing like that. Maybe whatever I am going to speak, all of you together, maybe knowing all of it. But as I always say, in a computer language, if a new program is to be installed, first it has to be downloaded. But after that, it has to be installed. And the problem with humans is we download a lot of things, but we don't install them into whatever we understand, whatever we knowledge we pick up. We are very good at it. But most of the times, the block is that whatever we have learned doesn't percolate inside, doesn't come into our personality, doesn't come into our actions. And that is why our growth is affected. So I would like all of you to sit here with a different perspective today, not like other lectures. Today I want everyone to sit here with the intention of picking up at least something from this lecture which will help you, which will clear the blocks in your mind and help you to apply things in your mind. For example, I'll give you an example. Three people, one is a mathematician, one is a physicist, one is an engineer. Three of them go to a conference and they are sleeping in different rooms. At night, the curtain catches fire. So engineer wakes up, he sees the fire. Immediately his mind reacts. Fire, he looks for water, takes water, throws it on the fire, extinguishes it, goes back to sleep. Now, fire starts also in a physicist's room.